Hey everybody, pack opening addict, box four time. Let's do this. I don't care that box two and three were disappointing. It still had some really cool stuff in it. You know, I have to say getting the Snapcaster and the Ancient Tome to kind of finish off the last one was a bit of a relief. And is once again proof that this set just, yeah, you can get some bum boxes, but you can also get a lot of awesome hits. So, let's open this last box out of the sealed case. Let's see where this goes. I enjoyed getting the Karn. That was fun. Okay. So we're just going to get right into this with good old, we're going to start off with Karn again. Ah, man, these, just when you think you have a rhythm with pull tabs, you don't. Treasure Cruise. And hey, Liliana showing up. Oh man, pack one. Pack one, Liliana. Oh. I mean, I don't, oh man. Woo. All right. I need a drink. Oh. That was, I did not expect that. Pack one, Liliana. Okay. So that's how you start off a box, ladies and gentlemen. That's how you start it off. And then Lava Spike. Rally the Peasants. War Leader Helix. And Commons. Okay. All right. You know what? We're not doing this. Excuse me. All right. Hold on. Oh, man. See, I hate how that kind of pulls it around the edge of that card right there. Oh, it's frightening. Okay. You know, we opened Liliana. We have to do the box topper now. Not that I care about views. Okay. So that is how all this stuff works, right? You're gonna get a pack one Liliana, and then you're gonna get a freaking Vengevine. Okay. Well, that's funny. Yeah, that's how this lottery goes. That is so funny. Such a contradiction. It could have just actually put everything through. That right there had the possibility to put the entire case up through the top. But obviously it didn't happen. That Vengevine, if I were to guess, it's what, probably 20 bucks or something. Because it's still a, you know, considered a good card, extended art, foil. Kind of a one-off design, so that's still kind of cool. Not to get too negative about that. To pull Liliana! Sorry, I'll calm it down. Hey, Noble Hierarch. Okay. Counter Squall, Magma, and Golgari Charm. Okay. So I have not seen a Phyrexian altar yet, which that's interesting. Sorry, I am struggling with this pack, not wanting to ruin everything inside of there. Oh, this pack just shredded apart like nobody's business. Okay. Visions of Beyond. Figures why it shredded apart. It's probably been repacked. Stupid repack packs. See, look at that. How? You can't get it out of there. Let's just go back to the regular packs, okay? Let's just do those. Desolate Lighthouse. You pull a Lily, and you're super excited. And then the next bunch of packs. I mean, I guess Noble Hierarch is fine, but the whole next bunch of packs are just absolutely god-awful. But we got Lily! Woo! Revel Arc. Eternal Witness, okay. And Pensipation Angel. All right. You know what would be awesome? Two Lilies, one box. Wild Mongrel, Spoils of the Vault. Okay. So we're going to start flying through some of these packs until I start seeing some heat. That is, as long as the pull tabs allow me to. Reviving Vapors. Snapcaster! Again! Hey, our second Snapcaster. You know, if you're going to get duplicate mythics, considering you're not going to get all the mythics in one case, that is one of the best ones to get. Awesome. Cool. I will take that. Yes, I know it's not two lilies, one box. But that's pretty sweet. Okay. So as of right now, we're about halfway through having a good box, and we haven't even gotten hits in the rares yet. Temporal Manipulation Foil. Nice. I was wondering when in the world we're going to hit a mythic foil. That is... Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Foil Temporal Manipulation into Kozilek, the Butcher of Truth. Oh my god. This box. See? They had to make it so all the other three were just missing the mythics. And this box was like, that's all right. I got them. You know what? I can't even get them straight right now. Hold on. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. See, that's a money pack. That's incredible. Okay. Let's keep going here. Entome for a yet another solid pick. Okay. Wow, Kozilek, Snapcaster Mage, Liliana, Foil Temporal. And yeah, Temporal's not the strongest, but out of the mythics, if you can at least pull a good one in foil, that's pretty cool. Fauna Shaman for yet another good rare. You know, I'd much rather have that than a foil Vengevine, that's for sure. All right, the question is, will we get one more mythic out of this box? We still have a lot of packs left. Cigara. I don't want to call it Sigrid. Probably opened up too much Kaldheim. Not one of the strongest. Not one of the weakest, but that's four mythics. Brazen Scourge, Unburial Rites. So we still have, wow, we still have a lot of packs to go here. We got four mythics already. That's interesting. Not even counting the foil one, since I kind of consider that slightly separate. It's really just a case hit out of the mythic foil. And I'm sorry, this pack does not want to open. It's a hell of a reseal job. Hell of a reseal job. Okay. And we got William Dafoe and Fulminator Mage. Yeah, okay. All right. Oops. Fumbling around here like a maniac trying to go fast. Oh, those pull tabs. Okay. And Engineered Explosives, one of those cards that used to be a money card, just like Fulminator Mage. But due to reprinting, not so much anymore. Not that it isn't still a used card. Okay. And Containment Priest. Oh, first time that's shown up. Okay, Chainer's Edict and the Hero. Okay, now we're starting to get into some of the regular parts of the box, but I have to imagine it's going to be one more strong rare at least. Celestial Colonnade, okay. So we got a foil rare. Could do worse there. Sovereign. Okay. Oh, find it interesting. It's one of a whole case. Haven't seen a Cavern of Souls yet. Again, not guaranteed all those, but Gedog Teague, so our second rare foil. Interesting. And Ruined Halo. Sigari Thug and Anger. Okay. So, after this, we got six packs left, so we'll be 75% of the way through the box. There's still going to be at least one more strong rare, maybe a mythic. Last Gasp, Seismic Assault, Kitchen Finks. Yeah, oops, sorry. Okay. So, let's do this. Final stretch. And then after this, I will make a just kind of an overall video with the whole case. Thespian Stage. Okay. So this particular box seemed to be very front-loaded with the mythics. All right, or they were all on one side with the way I took them out of the box. Seize the day. Okay. All right, Vengevine. You gotta have something good in your pack. Okay, and Celestial Colonnade. Great. Okay. All right, trying to do a race to the finish here. Okay. Forbidden Alchemy. Gamble. Okay, solid rare. Not quite the big rare I was hoping for, but still got two packs left. All right, two packs left, everybody. Oops. And this pack is now lightly played. Okay. I have to believe there's at least one more nice rare hit. There might even be one more mythic, but I'm not going to count on that. Kodaman's Reach Foil. Reanimate. So I guess between the Gamble and Reanimate, those two together kind of equal one big hit as far as rares go. So that might be it. Buried Alive. So last pack, everybody. So far, this box unquestionably was outstanding. This was a money box. This box makes up for box two, even with the subpar hit out of the box topper. Okay. Ruse Brother. Yeah, okay. So that's going to be it for this. After this, I'm going to just make a small one where just kind of go through really the $1 and up cards and the overall, you know, cost of the box across the case, really, versus what you kind of pulled out of it. I have a feeling this one's going to definitely swing a little bit more toward even, which, you know, that's solid EVs to get what you paid for, right? So, till that video, bye.